Okay, so I have the opportunity to coach a lot of creative entrepreneurs, and the people that I speak with primarily are either trying to get to the next level in their creative business, but a lot of them are really just getting started. They've maybe been selling their services on the side for at least a year or two, so they know what it's like to sell creative services and to charge money for whatever it is they do, but they really haven't even had the confidence to call themselves a business or an agency or a studio yet. It's just they still consider themselves free freelancers, and so they're wanting to take that next step to be a more professional company, and they don't really know how to get started. And so I've had this conversation recently actually with a few people, and the question is basically like, I don't really know how to get started in my creative business. And so here's a three-step plan. So if you're in that position and you're like wanting to start and you wanted to go to the next level to feel like you're like an actual company, you can leave this video and immediately implement, execute this, and you'll be good to go. The first thing you wanna do is find a product market fit. A lot of times, creatives, they could do a lot, right? They're designing logos, they're designing graphics for companies, they can do some website and user experience, they want to maybe make some social media content, so maybe we'll do some graphic design for social media, but then we'll also do a website, and it's just kind of like all over the place. So just because you have the capability of doing all these things doesn't necessarily mean that you should start your company as being the one-stop shop for everything. Now, again, I'm talking as an agency owner of Butler Branding, who we provide brand identity, graphic design, photography, videography, web design, digital marketing. However, I didn't start with just that. We started with logos and websites. That was it. As we started growing and we started being able to hire specialists and started to really gain expertise in other areas, then we were starting, we had the ability to add products and services to our catalog. But when you're first getting started, you have to figure out what is the product market fit? What is the one thing or two things or three things? You know, you figure out what the number is, but I would suggest no more than probably two or three things that you're gonna do as a creative business with the resources, ability, and time that you already have. Don't be dependent on having to hire a bunch of people or having to learn new skills that you don't already have. With the skills that you already have, what could you provide to businesses as a benefit to them? And you define that. So if you say, hey, I'm really good at logo design, or I'm really good at doing user experience strategy and building out layouts for websites, or I'm really good at just providing graphics for social media or doing photography. Well, just do that, figure it out. Define what it is your product or your service is that you're gonna offer. What are you providing? Who are you providing it for? What is the problem you're solving, and who are you solving that for? So that's your product market fit. Get really specific. What is it you're actually doing? Now, once you've done that, that's step one, is finding your product market fit. The next step is then to position your brand. Okay, so now you've determined this is the service that I want to offer for this type of audience. Well, now you have to position yourself. What does that mean? It starts with messaging. So you have to define what is your brand message? What is your elevator pitch? We have exercises to help you do all that. You know, part of the Butler Box, especially in the brand positioning course, helps you figure out what is your brand message? What is your tagline, your value proposition, your elevator pitch? What is your call to action? What is your specific offer? You have to really get dialed down to like, what are you offering people? What do you want people to do? How much are you gonna charge for that? So once you figure out your messaging, what you're gonna charge for your service, then you have to obviously do your brand identity. And that's not only your logo and branding guidelines, but also just the visual aesthetic of your brand. So the logo is a huge part of that. Then you get your messaging, your brand identity, and you create a website. Right? And so really there's three things that a business needs in order to be considered not fly by night. That's a logo, a business card, and a website. And yes, I said business card, people still use them, people hand them out. But once you have a business card, it kind of like solidifies the idea that you're a professional, you're a company, and that business card points people to your website. So you have your logo, your business card, your website has words, so you need brand messaging, and you need to have a clear call to action. So step one is finding your product market fit. Step two is position your brand with messaging, a logo, and a website. And then step three is marketing. a lot of the people that I coach are asking me, how do I market my services? How do I get more customers to buy whatever it is I'm selling? But they haven't done those first two steps. They're still kind of all over the place. They don't have a clean portfolio. They don't have a website that has a clear message to a specific audience with a clear call to action. They don't have any of that, and they're trying to go to marketing. You're not ready to market if you haven't defined your product market fit, if you have not positioned your brand. You're not ready to do the thing that you think you need to do, which is marketing. So once you've done those first two things, then you go to marketing. You're market ready. You're able to market yourself. And so how do you do marketing? Well, there's three categories of marketing. There's inbound, outbound, and networking. I would figure out two to three things you're gonna do in each one of those categories, put together a plan, and be consistent with that marketing plan for the next 4 to 6 months. The most important part, though, before marketing is brand positioning, because you're gonna spend a lot of time, effort, and money to try to market, but you're not positioned well. If you spend the upfront time strategizing, planning, positioning your brand, then you can do marketing. And again, those three categories is outbound, inbound, and networking. Figure out what activities you're gonna do in each one of those categories and be consistent for 4 to 6 months. Examples of outbound marketing activities could be old school knocking on a door, canvassing. I started like that. We just started, they had a website, I had some flyers and a business card. I don't recommend this for everybody, but that's how I got started. And I started knocking on businesses' doors and saying, hey, sorry to bother you, I'm a new agency in town, we offer creative services, and I wanted to leave my business card here just in case you guys needed our services at any time. And then I would take their business card and then I'd start to build relationships like that. That would be outbound marketing. I also did telemarketing. Again, I'm not recommending that you do this. I'm just saying these are forms of outbound marketing. I did it all. I did door knocking. I called businesses. I went to the county recorder's office physically. You could get all this information online now, but I physically went to the county recorder's office, got a list of all the new businesses, and I called all of them and I offered them a free resource. I didn't just say, hey, I'm trying to sell you something. I said, hey, we created a branding guideline. I think it was a free branding ebook, how to position your brand. And we're sending it all to all the business owners in Fresno. And so I just got a list of all the businesses and I emailed them this ebook, and I called them to do that. So now I got the business name, the owner's name, the email, and I was able to follow up. So that's outbound, is door knocking, calling, direct mail, the unsexy stuff that nobody wants to do, but hey, it actually works, because if you want the results that nobody has, you have to be willing to do the things nobody else is willing to do. Inbound marketing, that's the sexy stuff that everybody wants to do. That's positioning your brand to be so attractive that people are coming to you. The thing with inbound marketing, though, is it takes a lot of time and energy and effort. This is not I'm gonna create an ebook for people to download, I'm gonna create this lead magnet and everybody's gonna come flooding my inbox wanting all of my services, or I'm gonna share my work online and everybody's gonna start coming in every month. This is a long game thing. So you have to do things like sharing your work on social media, providing free resources, free content, being someone that is a resource or value to the audience that you're trying to serve. That's inbound marketing, to where your audience starts the conversation. Outbound is where you go out to them and you start a conversation. Inbound is where you're attracting the right customers to where they start the conversation. Outbound is more instantaneous, but it's difficult and tedious. Nobody wants to do it. Inbound is the best form, I believe, but it's also the long game. You're not gonna get results instantly. You have to be consistent for years, sometimes in inbound marketing. But again, you're in this for the long haul. Networking is tapping into other people's networks to expand your sphere of influence. And so if you're just getting started with your business, you don't have a huge network, I'm assuming, of a lot of business owners who can benefit from your services. And so you need to tap into other people's networks, and that's called networking. And that might be going to certain fundraiser events. It might be going to your local chamber of commerce or any kind of business networking groups. Where does your audience congregate? What are the events they're going to? Where are the places they're going to? And how can you get invited to the table to now expand your sphere of influence to where now you're rubbing shoulders with those people? And guess what you do? You hand out your business card, which links to your website where you've already positioned yourself. So three steps: product market fit, brand positioning, and then marketing. If you leave this video and you say, I still don't know where to start, then there's something wrong with you. If you have any questions, I want to hear them in the comments. Talk to you guys soon. Guys, thank you so much for watching this video. Please like and subscribe. Make sure this content gets out to more people. And if you are a creative entrepreneur and you're looking to level up, maybe you feel stuck, learn from my mistakes. At agency.butlerbranding.com, we have a free webinar that talks about everything I've learned in scaling Butler Branding since we started in 2012. I'm talking about everything I've learned from brand positioning, marketing, sales, strategy, and project management. So learn to level up for free at agency.butlerbranding.com.